last fishing trip. We're gonna see if see what's going on. I believe the All-Star baseball game starts in like an hour or two. So I'm going to see if I can catch a damn fish.
Alright. Wait. Swivel.
Yeah.
I did put some minnow in there.
Cool.
Alright. We're gonna use the good old dead sardines. And I actually have not tried them out here in this area. So, we are gonna give it a try. I don't really ever use fluorocarbon. But, we're gonna give it a try. I know this stuff's expensive, but there's a little bit on sale at West Marine. Figured, why not? You know? Alright, really simple rig. It's 40 pound, I guess. Probably could go like 30 or 20 in here. The 3-0 hook. Snail knot, really easy. Put it through. Wrap it around. Take the other end. Put it through the eye of the hook. Freaking good. Boom. Easy. Then uni knot on the snap swivel, or not snap, just regular swivel. Okay, it's gotta be the current, because I'm completely going backwards, though the wind is blowing. This doesn't make sense. So then, tie it on. By the way, on this reel, a lot of people ask me about it. I have no idea what model, whatever. It's an Avet, SX something. I've had a few people ask me about it in the videos, and I have no clue. I've had this reel for a long time. Very good reel. I want to turn the engine off, but I don't know what the hell my boat is doing right now. So, we're just gonna like not do that right yet. And I just do another U-knot. I do it four times when it's like a little bit like 30 pound test or higher. Actually no, 40 pound test or higher, I do it three times, and then under that, I do it four times. Okay. Now, allergens, fish, no shit. I bought bait. It's a box. It's like a box of bait. Of course, if you're allergic to fish, you should probably not buy a box of fish. There, we got a nice sardine, popsicle, this and that thing. And, I just do it through the eyes. Woo, that thing's smoking. Yo, by the way, it is so humid out. Oh my gosh. I'm gonna wait for this guy to pass. That guy's living a life right now. He's got a nice cigar, chilling. Alright, hopefully I don't. This is the first cast. I respooled this last night. Let's hope I don't bird's nest it, because this kind of feels loose. Okay. The bait went way the hell there. The weight. Okay. That'll do, I think. That'll do. What? No, I don't like that. like, I still have not really been fishing this area at all, but a lot of people have told me there's snook and tarpon that chill in the waterway here. Okay, it's just gonna have to do that. The weight's not. I made the leader a little bit too big for this. The weight doesn't want to slide all the way down. So a lot of people said snook and tarpon stuff in here. I know snook like sardines. I'm assuming tarpon don't care either. I want to see what else is in here though. That's nice of that guy. Did he slow down because I'm fishing? That's really nice. Alright. Another thing I see people have asked me numerous times in the comments is about mangrove snapper fishing. Like, I know one person on Instagram asked me, and then I've seen a few people asking me in the comments. We're going to try it out, because I'm going to do what I tell everyone to do. Let's see if I'm about right. I actually don't have the right hooks. Do I? I lied, I do have the right hooks. Okay. Yeah. Alright, so. Mangrove snapper. Do I have the right leader, though? Keep getting distracted. Still have not quite figured this area out. I assume a lot of people said to like go up and down here trolling, like what are they called? They call it like bomber lures or something. They're like the big like they look like a big finger mullet or something. I like dive down, and they said to like watch the depth finder and find like big holes that are like down in the middle of like the channel kind of deal. I think I did that like once or twice. But I know there's a bunch of docks up and down here that have snook lights on them. I'm gonna go try that out. It's almost dark. It's just this boat really sucks for fishing back here. Like, especially dock fishing, and especially when I'm by myself. Like the one night my buddy and I went up and down once and we caught a couple of snook. And no problem with that because he can fish and I'd drive the boat. When I'm by myself? A little more pain in the ass. I think I need a lot lighter. This is like 40 pound something. I need like. But whatever. And I was gonna go fishing offshore today. But I woke up at like 6 something and I heard a ton of thunder and I was like, alright, I'm going back to bed. Probably should have checked the radar because I'm sure it went right by, but I don't know, I might try it tomorrow. It's kind of windy right now. I'm going back at it. And they reset this and bouncing again like it's going to hit, but I'm just going to let whatever the hell is going to do it. So, yeah, mangrove snapper. Exact same setup as usual. Just a little smaller hook. I like the. If you get like longer shank hooks, this is like a 1-0 whatever Mustad thing, and if you get longer shank ones, that's a little bit better because then mangroves won't bite you off. Here, I'll put it like through its head, kind of, because they're going to be picking at it, and I don't want to just knock the bait off. So, it's actually not a good time, because it's, from my understanding, is that it's low tide, and there's not a lot of, water. So, like, the fish can't really, whoa, things are happening. I know exactly what I'm talking about, mangroves. Yeah, it's like, I don't know, these things are like everywhere. This is what I hate about mangrove fishing. This part. If you don't know mangroves, look at them damn toothless. These don't. This one's probably, I think they're 8 inches or whatever, but I don't like catching mangroves really. Because, like, if you want to eat them, you got to get, like, 15 of them. I mean, they're delicious. Because, like, when we go down the marathon in the Keys, we catch, we'll catch a bunch of them if we haven't really caught many fish. Just to feed everyone. I mean, I'll eat, like, damn near anything. And my one buddy, who's, like, really good at mangrove fishing, catches, like, all the big, damn big ones. He likes, like, jig heads, just that, whatever bait you're using. Like, greenies, sardines. I should probably be using smaller chunks of sardine, but mangrove, like, docks, rock pile, like, I mean, rock pile with that really big house down there. You can't really see it here. Some docks, bridge, but anywhere there's like structure, like kind of like that, there should be mangroves. Is it still frozen enough? Can I break it? That's something I never bring fishing, is a knife. Right. I was definitely looking that way and I got hit. It's definitely just swimming with it right now. What could it be? I'm gonna go with jackfish. Okay, we're moving. Oh my gosh, this spot sucks. This spot sucks. No, not to get close to these fucking things, because my dad, if you don't know, was a podiatrist, aka foot doctor, and when I was little, he was like, hey, you like to fish a lot, take a look at this x-ray. And the x-ray was from a guy who, apparently stepped on a catfish I guess he caught or something. I don't know what the story behind that was. But he stepped on it and the barb went through his tennis shoe and into his foot. It must have been a big catfish too, because it was like a pretty decent sized barb. And my dad had to like surgically remove it for him. And I was like, well, you know what, Dad? I'm not going to do that. I'm gonna avoid catfish at this point. Oh my gosh, that bird would take it. There's like no wind, and that guy's totally gonna hear me talking as well. Okay, something's happened. Hopefully, this is not another kitty. This feels like a jack. That's just pulling in a head shake. Okay, my throwing line got bigger than I was feeling. Alright, that works. It's actually. Jack? It's actually a little bit bigger than I thought it was. It's actually a lot bigger than I thought it was, because like he was barely pulling the kayak here. This one definitely should have fought a lot harder than it did. Okay, apparently the snapper loved the big pieces of sardine, because I threw in like that whole piece that was left. That was like instant bites. That looks exactly. Little mangrove. got you guys at home watching me fish. And this couch. That one's probably like an inch or two short. I'm pretty sure it's 8 inches. This is about a good size. Come on, I know there's a big man around there. Is that what's his face? I know the sock. I'm totally blanking out on the guy. The sock's called Hard Floor. Oh man, who's the guy? Kevin. That's his name. What's his name? Kevin. Oh my gosh. I can't believe I'm blanking out on this. I'm triggered. They're like both listening to different rap songs and it sounds really weird. It's by Kevin Gates. That's, I had to go look that up. That shit was pissing me off. I like that guy. This is 100% catfish. That's not even like full on. Jesus, dude. Catfish, really bad spot. I wish. Something better than this. Come on. There's gotta be some water Pokemon around here. I don't even know. Oh, there's a Squirtle somewhere. I've already caught all the damn Magikarp and Jupiter. Mullet mod over there. Come on. Let's see. What kind of cool ass Pokemon do I have? Show my level. That's what I got. That's what I'm working with right now. I don't even know if it's coming out of the game right now. Hopefully it is, or else this is gonna be pointless. I took over a gem earlier today. But I think it got defeated because it gave me the Pokemon back that was there. Which I'm pretty sure was this Execute, which is only level 202. And the one I took it over, the guy had like a Pinsir, I think, that was like a 300 something, and I killed it with mine. And I just put the Execute there. But I totally messed up because I would have put my Smokin' Weedle in there. And that would have been easy, but that would have been pretty troll to do that. I should have did that. But I'm going to go back tomorrow and take that thing. Missed out. Damn it, Pokemon! Trying to catch fake animals and then the real animals are here? This is not how you do it, by the way, because, like, putting a hook just through frozen sardine skin, that's. They're just gonna pick this off real quick. Ooh, that was a good cast. That almost went over the thing. I think the weight is in a thing of mangrove. So this might get caught right there. I'm pretty sure the only way I get this rig back right now is if I do catch a fish and the fish swims away around the rock. Whatever is it? There's things right there. I like it when it does this. And then sometimes it'll find Pokemon. You know what we're gonna do? We're gonna drop a lure. Alright, instant. Where do I know? I don't know, I think this is like an amazing idea for a video game, and I'm really interested to see if, like, how they continue updating it or whatever. I mean, when I was little, I absolutely went apeshit over Pokemon. So why the hell is there a Caterpie in the middle of the water? It's a level 75 Caterpie. I just screenshot that. Pokemon Red and Blue that was like on the Game Boy. I played the shit out of those games. All the Pokemon cards, I was all crazy about that. Probably like the original 151 Pokemon. All these other ones, it's like, I saw one recently, I think it's from like the new generation, I guess it would be, Pokemon, and it's like a piece of trash or something. It's like, what the hell? But I'm sure kids who grew up with the new Pokemon now feel the same way I did about the old Pokemon growing up with them. So I guess it works out, you know? Oh my gosh, the wind's really starting to die out right now. I was like, oh, the bait's coming. Alright, this is another catfish. Jesus, dude. They're just getting bigger, too. It is so humid. Holy shit. If you guys want to experience, you want to feel like to get the full fishing experience right now with me, and you find like a spray bottle that's like clean, put some water in it, and every time you breathe in, just like squirt it in your face. So it's like a huge mist going in your nose and mouth. That's basically what it's like right now. And if you can, go get eaten up by a bunch of bugs. Because these bugs are tearing me up. Okay, I don't think I'm going to stay. Walking around trying to. Where did that come out? There's a raccoon right there. I wonder if I can get it with my bigger camera. Oh, there's like a bunch of raccoons.
I can't zoom in far enough. It's like right here, kinda. I think you'd see his face. There's like a couple of them in there. I must be getting like a drink of. Something, what are there, one, two? I think there's two.
What do I look like when I'm like fishing? Like, oh, I look like an idiot. Yeah, this is like what I use on, when the video is really good quality, this is the camera I'm using. And you can probably tell when it's the GoPro. So, I wish I could just use this, but I like the GoPro. I don't even have to worry. Like this, I don't want to get wet. And then this, I don't care about because it's waterproof. Okay, so I'm gonna go. I might, if this video keeps going, then I did. I might try and go back out once it's completely dark. And I'm sure I can see one guy in the smoke that I was talking about now. But I know there's a few other ones, so I'm gonna wait till it's like really dark out. And I might go back up and do a run and see if something's happening.
Shall see.